I find fuel for my work in a variety of aspects of the way the world is, its wonder and its perplexities. So these prompts, as it were, can come from a very wide variety of positions. And my task is to somehow convert these elements in the world into something that a person might share with me, at least at some level.
Roger's work is important for so many reasons. For one, it lies at the nexus of science and art. So coming from an engineering background and from a performative background as a pianist in his earliest days, he mixes these two things in a way that, first of all, is unique in the musical world, and secondly, and importantly, symbolizes the work that everybody does here at UC San Diego, crossing boundaries between science and art and humanities.
It seems to me that disciplines now, all of them, are becoming more complex, and because they become more complex, they become also more specialized. And what that means is that it's increasingly difficult to move outside the space that you have established. So it seems to me that it's important to be aware of the fact that one is bounded and to find ways for moving outside of those spaces that are familiar and habitual.
To someone who's not heard Roger's music, one way to describe it is music that saturates the senses and the intellect all at the same time. So very often Roger will use electronics to extend the palette of sounds that a live performer will make. And because he often links his pieces with dramatic themes, a new piece for the Jack Quartet on the history of flight, for example, a piece that he wrote for me based on the tragedies of Aeschylus, piece after piece that makes a sonic impression but also a dramatic impression. So if you come to hear a piece of Roger's, you should be ready to be both moved and stimulated.
I'm very much interested in great public spaces, using non-traditional contexts for music. I'm interested in theater and video, dance, and particularly in sonic spatialization. Technology has been an extremely important tool for me. And at this point, it seems to me that technology is valuable both in terms of how it can change what music has to say, but also that it enlarges the range of people who can experience it.
He's provided a model for what it means to work hard on one's craft. So you watch his graduate students watching him, learning what it means to work, to craft something.
The students that our department attracts from all over the world are remarkable. They're a pleasure to work with, a challenge. The range of things that are done here and done well is unprecedented. So it has turned out to be a very nice place to be. Our travels continue, but this is home.
Roger has been there for all of us for such a long time, both as a creative artist, and in my personal case, giving me this amazing music to play. But he's also been there for the department and for the university as a leader and a guiding light, actually.
So it's important to be in a situation where you can recontextualize familiar things. You can begin to try to address questions, issues, opportunities that have emerged in the world of which you were unaware before. And of course, it's also important, I think, to be using new resources, and technology is a part of that, a part of the range of new tools, new experiences, new references that we have to work with as artists in our time.